almost all of us would have personally experienced or would have seen a close relative or a friend experiencing a bleeding from the nose. It appears very scary. Is it really dangerous? Let's see in today's video. Hi friends, I am Dr. Karamat and this is Scientific Doctor Channel. In this channel, every Wednesday, videos are being released on common medical topics. If you want to see such videos, kindly subscribe to this channel. Also press the bell icon for instant notification on new videos. Today's topic is going to be on bleeding from the nose or epistaxis as we technically call it. Usually, it is a very common childhood problem and more often than not, in childhood, though it is scary, it is not usually seriously problematic. It is so common that by the age of 10 years, at least 60% of all children would have had one episode of nose bleeding. There are two types of epistaxis. One is called anterior or from the front part of the nose. The second is called posterior or from the back part of the nose. Anterior epistaxis is usually harmless, usually happens more often in children. Posterior epistaxis could be problematic, happens more often in adults. What are the causes of nose bleeding? In children, the most common cause is nose picking and vigorous blowing of the nose. Dry air, like when you are in air-conditioned rooms or when the humidity is less, can also lead to this. Injuries to the face can result in nasal bleeding, as also bleeding tendencies. Bleeding tendencies are a group of disorders in which there is not only bleeding from the nose but also from other sides, like you can have skin bleeds which can manifest as some rashes or bleeding from other sides like bleeding when you are passing urine. Coming to the causes of epistaxis in adults, apart from the before mentioned causes, arteriosclerosis, that is thickening of the blood vessels, can lead to bleeding in them. Also, rule out hypertension in any adult who has this bleeding from nose after 40 to 45 years of age. Having seen the causes of bleeding from nose, how does it happen? Why does it happen only in the nose? For this, we must understand the anatomy of the nose. Only in nose, the blood vessels are very close to the surface and there is only mucosa which is covering it. Mucosa is a plastic sheet like layer which covers the surface, inner surfaces of the body. So whenever you have a cold, because of vigorous blowing or nose picking, just trying to clean the nose, these result in mucosal damage. And when the mucosa is damaged, the blood vessels which are already on the surface covered only by the mucosa are directly exposed. Also, whenever there is a cold or a allergic rhinitis, these lead to inflammation, that is swelling, redness. This can result in higher tendency for bleeding. As I told in the initial part of the video, in children, though it is scary, it is usually nothing to worry about. But when should you worry about bleeding from the nose? When should you rush to a doctor or a health facility? The following are the danger signs whenever there is a severe blood loss due to bleeding from the nose. How can we assess what is a severe blood loss? When the person has symptoms of severe blood loss, like fainting, weakness, dizziness, lightheadedness, all this may indicate a degree of blood loss which is not simple and you should rush to the doctor. When the person has bleeding disorder, as I already told, bleeding not only from the nose, from the wound site if it bleeds heavily, or there are skin rashes looking like bleeds into the skin, or bleeding from any other site like bleeding when he passes stool or bleeding when he passes urine. So these conditions indicate a bleeding disorder, that is a problem in the coagulation mechanism. They also have to be taken to the hospital immediately. Also, when the nose bleeds happen recurrently multiple times, you have to visit the hospital to assess the cause. What should you do as a first aid at home in case of simple bleeds or even when there are danger signs before you reach the hospital? The first and foremost thing is to sit or stand straight with the hip slightly bent forward. You should not bend backwards, because if you bend backwards, the bleeding is to go into the stomach. Because if it can go into the stomach, it can lead to other problems like vomiting and gastric irritation. Once you are in an erect, slightly forward leaning posture, you should pinch both the nostrils in the lower part of the nose. The lower, the forward part of the nose where it is soft. The upper inner part is made up of bones, but the lower, softer part you have to pinch. Even if the bleeding is from one side of the nose, you have to pinch both the nostrils simultaneously and you should apply pressure continuously. The important word here is continuous, because if you apply pressure intermittently and leave the pressure to see whether there is bleeding or not, the bleeding is not going to stop. For children, we say you should apply pressure for at least 5 minutes and for adults, we say around 10 minutes. You can also keep a cold compress or ice pack over the bridge of the nose. Though it doesn't completely resolve the problem, it might be of little help. If the bleeding doesn't stop or if there are danger signs, you should visit the hospital. On reaching the hospital or the doctor, what are the tests done for the diagnosis of epistaxis or nose bleeding? Usually, no test is required if the bleeding is simple and it is easily controlled. But if there are bleeding disorders, as I mentioned before, there might be blood tests required. What is the treatment for this? As I said, the first aid usually suffices in most of the cases, especially in children when the cause is usually nose picking or vigorous blowing. If it is a severe bleed, or if the bleeding is from the back part of the nose, posterior bleeding, as I said in the initial part of the video, or if the bleeding is in adults, you might require intervention like packing, where a gauze soaked in medication is inserted into the nose to arrest the bleeding. If the bleeding still doesn't stop, there are measures to identify the blood vessel and to cauterize it to stop the bleeding. We have come to the end of this video. We have to realize most of the nosebleeds are harmless but scary in nature. They are most often occur due to vigorous blowing or nose picking. So both these things should be avoided. And when there are danger signs or if the bleeding doesn't stop, you have to immediately go to the doctor. This was a short video on epistaxis or nose bleeding. If you like this video, kindly share it among your friends and relatives also. If you want to see such videos, subscribe to this channel. Till the next video, bye.